Saludos amigos de Pío Deportes. Estamos con Tyrus Wade y Chris Moore, hombres importantes, importantísimos en la victoria del día de hoy de Huellas del Siglo. Tyrus, Chris, thanks a lot for being here with us. We really, really, really appreciate it. Talk to us about this game, this really important game, which you defeat San Carlos team, one of the best teams in this tournament.
Man, first of all, man, I just want to give praise and thanks to Lord Jesus Christ, man, for blessing us and giving us an opportunity to come out here and play again, man. You know, me and T Wade, man, we were both tired tonight, man. But you know, when you come with a lot of heart, man, and a lot of dedication, a lot of pride, man, you can go through anything. You know what I'm saying? I missed a lot of easy shots tonight. I was tired, but it's still no excuse. Big Dog, he held me down, man. He came through, made a lot of big three-pointers in the fourth quarter to help open the game. Coach drew up some good plays for him to get him open and to get him going late in the game. And another win, man. We just blessed.
Talk to us about this game, Tyrus. You went now crazy in the last half. 6 3-pointers in that half, 7 at all.
It was just the rhythm thing for me. So, you know what I'm saying? First half, legs was dead, tired or whatever, but my teammates and coach did a great job of telling me to stay in there. That was big because confidence is key when you're shooting. So my coach and teammates never got down on me. He pumped me up every game to go ahead and turn up. So when you got your teammates behind your back like that, it makes it easier to make shots.
Le preguntamos con relación a este juego tan importante que derrotaron al conjunto de San Carlos. Nos dice primero Chris Moore que, gracias a Dios, él no tuvo un buen partido. Y Tyrus Wade nos dice que, gracias a Dios, todo salió bien para ellos. Y aquí tenemos entonces a Derek Baker López. Baker, 2 victorias de manera consecutiva.
Ay, sí, de verdad. Así mismo. Quiero decir, yo confío en mi equipo entero. Y está frío por 3 cuartos y medio. Y cuando le prende la luz, ya tú sabes, el aro está abierto. Él mete todo después. Y él comienza a meter la bola cuando yo pongo él en el banco. Y es eso. Yo pongo él en el banco y comienza a meter la bola. Después él entró y ya nosotros fui termina bien, bien, bien. Gracias.
Tyrus, talk to us about how did you feel in this game? Just like Derek Baker López say, first half you wasn't so hot, even though you have 8 points. But in the second half, you were now just crazy. Talk to us about the strategy for this game.
We're trying to get into the playoffs, first of all. So we knew we had to not just only beat them, but kind of try to beat them by make up some points from the last time. And so I had kind of like a little sour taste in my mouth last time we played them. We had a whole different system, whole different coaching staff, and I felt like we weren't given the best opportunities to go out there and play like we could. So when you play against a team that killed you before, it's kind of like you have a chip on your shoulder. And so I never forgot that they beat us by 30-something points before that. So when we had them, we just tried to keep our foot on their neck. And like I say, my teammates just responsible for that fourth quarter. I didn't even play good the third quarter, really. Missed free throw. It was the fourth quarter. My coach had them telling me to keep playing. And then this guy right here telling me to just go ahead and put your foot on their neck.
Le preguntamos con relación a este partido. Nos dice que ellos tenían que venir a ganar y ganar por una buena cantidad de puntos, porque el primer partido frente a ellos mismos le ganaron por mucho. Entonces él entiende que fue todo gracias a un trabajo en equipo. Él no tuvo un buen tercer cuarto, sin duda, no tuvo un buen tercer cuarto, pero sus coaches, sus dirigentes siempre se mantuvieron diciéndole: sigue tirando, sigue haciéndolo, sigue intentándolo, que todo saldrá bien.
Tyrus and Chris, you were talking about behind the scene that you are like Kobe and Shaq and those Lakers. Talk about this confidence of you, both of you.
We just had to go on a run. When I came here, see, I already knew Big Dog because he got a good reputation around the world from playing in other countries. So I already knew, you know, once I came, it was time to roll, you know what I'm saying, because I already knew he could go. And the pieces around you, you know what I'm saying, once they start fitting the right way, man, you know, the sky's the limit, man. So once we got a little rhythm in the first game, That's been, you know what I'm saying, how we've been riding with it for the last three games. And we're going to keep on trying to keep it going, you know?
Yo estuve preguntando, aquí estuvieron hablando detrás de cámara, de que ellos son como el Kobe y el Shaq de los Lakers del 2000 al 2003 cuando ganaron los campeonatos. Y yo le dije, ¿por qué esa confianza entre ellos? Y él estuvo diciendo de que al principio, ellos no, en los dos primeros juegos donde ellos participaron, no tuvieron ese ritmo y esa confianza. Pero luego, en estos dos últimos partidos, han tenido ese ritmo y esa confianza y que el cielo es el límite para ellos dos.
Chris, Tyrus, you are two veteran players. You are playing now with players like Jason Valdez, Victor Verdesia, some really, really good kids. Talk to us how you fit in with their playing style.
Those kids, man, look, they talented. You know, when Coach Baker came in, he started putting that mindset in the right frame. He started changing how they think in the game, you know. And that's probably was the biggest problem, you know what I'm saying? That's probably why he wasn't getting off like he was supposed to before I came, because he's a big-time player, you know what I'm saying? And now he's getting off because now Coach Baker, he's really changing everything and really forming these guys into the roles that they really supposed to be in, which allows him and myself to do what we do, and then everybody else play their supporting role. So really you got to give it to the coaching for, you know what I'm saying, for making everything, you know, formed in the right way.
Like he said, everything. Before it was just wild, wild west out there on the court, and then nobody had a role, and they really weren't trying to include the imports and stuff like that. But now they bought into the system, you know what I'm saying? Baker, you're trusting your coach is everything. So everybody bought into it, from us believing in them as well. We can't just go out there and not include them. So the pieces are coming together. If it was like this from the beginning, you don't know what it would have been like.
Le preguntamos con relación a ellos dos como jugadores veteranos y su experiencia hasta el momento con jugadores nobles, con jugadores novatos, como lo es el caso de Jason Valdez y de Víctor Verdesia. Nos dice que este coach, Derek Baker López, ha logrado hacer que estos jugadores hagan el trabajo que tengan que hacer, que tienen que hacer. Ellos entienden que anteriormente no tenían un rol definido y era una especie del salvaje oeste o del viejo oeste. Y por esa adecuación que ha hecho el coach López es que ellos en estos partidos han tenido buena participación, buena actuación, porque cada uno de ellos, cada uno de los jugadores está haciendo su trabajo.
Last question for me. Tyrus, you were so hot all the game, man. What was the focus before the game?
Man, every game is the same for me, man. Especially with us in opposition. Every game is like playoffs for us. If we lose, we might not have no chance to go into the postseason. So I don't play for anything else but to get the win. So that's just my focus. Every game is the same for me. Play it like my last. Every game could be my last. You know what I'm saying?
Yo le estuve preguntando, yo le estuve diciendo que él estuvo muy caliente durante el partido, durante todo el partido, y le pregunté que cuál fue el foco de él antes del mismo. Y él dijo que para él todos los partidos son iguales, todos los partidos son para llegar a los playoffs, y que para él no existe el perder, sino ganar, y todos los partidos ellos están enfocados en ganar.
All right, thanks a lot for both of you guys for taking this minute to talk to us. We really appreciate it. We wish you good luck the rest of the tournament, and let it be. I know you're tired. You play 40 minutes, both of you. So we really appreciate it. Thanks a lot.